You're a leader. There's no one in your family, your friends, or your peer group who really understand what you're facing and how hard it really is. And so more than anything, the loneliness needs to be fought with optimism and hope and with surrounding yourself with people like you. You are part of a unique tribe. And we're not born into this tribe. You may be lucky. You may have a mentor or a friend who you looked up to, who showed you what entrepreneurship meant, what taking on risks meant, what being a leader meant. And you may be able to look up to them. But most of us don't. Most of us are on this path and we have this idea and this dream. And it's not that people think we're crazy. They just don't get how hard it really is. They don't get how easy it is to slip into the feelings that I don't have it. I'm not good enough. I can't do this. Who am I to think I can do this? They don't understand the challenges and the worries we face because it's more than just finances and managing cash flow and team. Every single win is a win that we don't feel like we can take credit for. And every single loss is our fault. And when you live in this world all day, every day, it's lonely and it's hard. And so you need to find that tribe. That tribe of people who are just like you. You know, my son, I have four kids. My oldest son is turning 11. He is off the wall. He's crazy and kind of loud, and he comes across as obnoxious if you don't really know him, but he's full of life and spirit. And so we decide that we're gonna put him in drama camp. And he's never done it, he's never done any acting, and I was so proud of him. He comes home from drama camp one weekend, and he literally says to me, "You know what, I'm so happy. This is my favorite place I've ever been." I was like, "Why? Why, Jonah?" And he goes, "I finally feel like I found other people who are just as crazy as me, and I feel like I fit in." And I was like, that is like super deep for a 10 or 11 year old. And so I waited a day. I was really proud of him for that. And I said, "Who did you hear that from? Like, did someone say that? Did an instructor say it? Did a friend say it?" And he looked at me, he's like, "No, I came up with that myself." So he's 10 years old, 11 years old, and in our family of six, he doesn't feel like he quite fits in. Out in his friend group, at church, at school, he doesn't feel like he fits in, but here he feels like he fits in because he's surrounded himself with people who get his energy, who get his quirkiness, who get all of the spirit that he brings to things that other people find obnoxious. But in that group, he fits in. So when you think of yourself as a leader, who fits the definition of those who will fit your group? I have to be around optimistic people because otherwise I slip into pessimism. I'm scrolling on Instagram yesterday and I see Forbes post something for a house in Colorado that's being sold for $78 million. It's insane. I'm not in any position right now to be able to do that. It's just that I need to make sure that I surround myself with business leaders and with people where I go, $78 million, cool, eh? And they go, "That could happen. I don't know how. That can happen. Sure. Go do it," right? That's the little thing that you need to look for in the tribe of people you surround yourself with. The hope, the optimism. What about the push, right? The people who aren't gonna let you be comfortable getting by, making excuses, or skating by. The people who will interrupt your pattern because I'm busy worrying about this staff member, and they go, "Staff member's not who you should be worrying about. You should be worrying about your culture," right? Sales isn't what you should be worried about. You hate your business. You're not even happy coming into work. That's what you should be focusing on. Like, who is the person who is calling you on the BS? Who is going to hold you accountable for getting better? The person who's going to point out, because you know what, if you're the leader, you're probably in a position where no one in your life is comfortable criticizing you because you have an answer for everything. But you need that person who's gonna call you out. And when you have the answer for it, they get around it. They don't listen to your great reasons. They don't accept the fact that you have the confidence on the spot and you're gonna answer. They're gonna say, no, stop that. This is what you should be focusing on. And who are the people who are gonna make you aware of your blind spots? Who are the people who are gonna help raise the next level and show you the path of what's possible? Who are the people who are gonna give you a taste of that thing that you can't achieve right now, but you want it so badly that you wanna go out there and get it? And so the most obvious examples as a leader is if you are in business and you surround yourself with people where you are the best, you're comfortable, where do you have to go? Go to a new market and realize that you're garbage. Realize you don't have the team, you don't have the experience, you're not good enough, you will not make it in New York City. It's too competitive, it's too hard, there are too many people who are just like you, right? Now you're gonna go to a whole new level. You go and work out at the gym. You can go to the gym where you're the best in the class, or you can go and surround yourself with people who are three levels higher than you, and every time you leave, you feel like garbage because you are not as good as them. But stick with it, push through, have the hope, have the optimism, and guess where you're gonna be? Like, they didn't start there. No one starts at the level that you see them at. They start with nothing, and then they progress and get up and move up if they're willing to stick with it, if they're willing to push through, if they surround themselves with people who are gonna cheer them on, if they believe it's possible. And so this environment is not going to happen to you. People are not gonna come along and form a group around you. You need to find these people. You need to find them online. You need to find them on Instagram or on a call or in your local neighborhood or your business group or whatever it is. You need to find these people. Second, you can't just accept that just because there's a group of entrepreneurs around, they are awesome entrepreneurs. You can't. You need to be very, very careful who you allow to influence your life. People look awesome on Instagram, their lives might be a mess. They have an amazing business you look up to, they may have sacrificed everything for that business and you're not willing to sacrifice those things. You may join an entrepreneur group and you kind of think that they're pretty good, but 6 months in you realize they're not actually interested in doing the accountability, in taking the next steps, in being optimistic, in being all of those things that I need to get to the next level. They just want to sit around and pat each other on the back and do soft updates and not tell the truth. Or maybe you're the truth bringer and you love bringing the truth to others, but you have trouble tapping into, you know, your heart or your spirit or your relationships. You need to put yourself in a situation where you are with leaders like you. And this is something you have to do now. Don't wait for a month. Don't wait till next year. If you want to see the instant transformation this will have in how you feel and how you carry yourself, you have to do this like today.
Growing and scaling your business by being better at sales and better at marketing, better at customer experience is important to you. Be sure to check out this video right over here. And like always, subscribe to my channel, click on the bell icon, and get each video every day when it drops.